Well, good morning, everybody. It's great to be here, and thanks for changing the location over here to our fire station. This morning, like we do every week, we're going to talk about some of the great events happening this week, and two that go along with our vision for a safer, stronger, smarter community, Vision 2020. We're going to talk about how do we become safer, how do we build a stronger community, and how are we doing things smarter at the City of Spokane. We do have a busy week coming up here as we lead up to Spokane Gives Week, and we're going to invite a couple of our partners up after we start with our paperless patient record that we're going to be implementing here in the City of Spokane. And again, as we talk about becoming a safer community and our vision for that, our vision for having a stronger social service network and partners in the nonprofit world, and quite frankly, I think today we'll highlight the ways we're doing things smarter. I also want to spend a couple minutes highlighting a new mapping tool that will allow our citizens to better help us in our transportation planning, another way of building a stronger community with our transportation infrastructure, but doing it in a smarter way, one that engages our citizens in a whole new way of doing business. But first, I'm excited to be here today with our Assistant Chief Brian Schaefer to talk about what we're doing here in the fire department, and that's why I thought it would be key that we're here and you can see how we're implementing it, talk to our first responders and the amazing work that they do on a daily basis and doing it in a smarter way. Electronic patient records make us safer city because we're doing things in a smarter, more electronic and 21st century way. The implementation of this year-long project that allows the department's firefighters and paramedics to provide better medical care to our citizens and to our visitors. The patient care reporting, the electronic patient care reporting system, allows for electronic collection of patient information as a replacement to the traditional paper report that has been the routine for the department, quite frankly, since 1884. It's exciting to partner today also with those that provide medical care. I spent the morning with some of our critical care providers and talking about how do we do things smarter going into the future. The Spokane Fire Department responds to more than 33,000 incidences this last year in 2013. 86% of those had emergency medical service components. So whether it was the primary reason or the secondary reason, obviously the vast majority of them have medical emergency system components of them. That translated into more than 20,000 patient care reports. This initiative will significantly improve our service by, one, equipping firefighters and paramedics with portable tablets to collect real-time patient and incident information. Secondly, to ensure compliance with all HIPAA and state Washington State regulation requirements for protecting the privacy of patient records and our citizens, which are maintained and stored in secure databases. The third, it'll quickly and accurately generate a patient's report in a uniform and comprehensive manner, resulting in better documentation of higher levels of service. Fourth, it'll comply with Washington State and Center for Disease Control, the CDC repository, used for collection and analysis of incident-level patient care records used to positively impact the future services by providing and improving on the current practices provided by our emergency medical system. The EPCR implementation is one of many steps to develop a comprehensive approach to integrated medical care with local hospital systems, public health organizations, and the city's ambulance vendor. The Spokane Fire Department's EMS division worked through an exhaustive process to research, test, and select an affordable and flexible EPCR platform. This tool gives the city's firefighters and paramedics the ability for better care for citizens at a time when they most are at need. The Spokane Fire Department is also leveraging the EPCR system capability to provide detailed analysis of incidents, procedures, status report preparations, monitoring, and corrective action requirements, as well as customizable reports to meet our public's need for information. The technology also allows for real-time information to be sent to key personnel. This in particular is important in the event of catastrophic or widespread conditions that occur that could be affecting the public's need for medical response. The department will be able to provide rapid, appropriate, and timely response based upon current conditions in the field. this is an investment that is in technology, but also in training and infrastructure, was made possible through the funding of the city's EMS levy. It's also been a complete integrated with, it's completely integrated with existing systems, including computer-aided dispatch, records management system, LifePak monitoring defibrillators, and the state of Washington's Department of Licensing barcodes on the state IDs and driver's license systems. So as you can see, a lot of work has come together on this. It integrates a substantial amount of the technology already in place and truly is a smarter way of doing business. Just for a way of seeing what it looks like on scene, and you can talk to some of our paramedics, in essence, it is a tablet, a patient record that really fully integrates many of the pieces out there. And if you have a word or two, Brian, I'll turn it over to you.
Obviously, I'll be brief. I've made an opportunity available for everybody to speak with the primary project lead, Tim Lonkin, to get your hands on and some B-roll of the device itself. But like the mayor mentioned, exhaustive process is truly our first step into integrating the Spokane Fire Department care capability with the larger community. So the system all starts with data. We'll finally be able to track real-time data, quality data, and make decisions based on that data from a policy standpoint. So this is a big day for the Spokane Fire Department. Thanks.
Thank you, Chief. And again, a way as we implement this shows the innovation that our city is doing, and really the implementation just started a few hours ago. Today is the launch of that as we begin that process of implementing it across the system. Secondly, and I'll ask the chief and the commissioner to join me here, I just want to, come on, chief. It's great to have Commissioner O'Quinn with us, and I'll just always say what she says, the best thing about Spokane is it's entirely in the county of Spokane. And I would have to agree with her, and especially today, to just highlight the partnerships that Spokane Gives Week, which will be kicked off this Saturday with Cleaning from the Core and several other events. And I would ask that you go to the website Spokane Gives and see the events that are across our county. Also, just this last week, our great partners out at Fairchild are partners in this also. We obviously support what they do, but in so many ways, week in and week out, the support of our airmen and our service members that serve at Fairchild is integral about being a part of our community, because they are. Many of them live, go to school, and a lot of their spouses work in our community while they serve our country based out of Fairchild. Spokane's response has been tremendous to the Spokane Gives initiative that was announced last month. Nearly 100 projects from across the county, from as far south as Freeman, some in Deer Park, in Spokane, the city of Spokane Valley, and across, 100 projects are now entered through SpokaneGives.org, and Spokane has been volunteering unbelievably. We do have needs for more than 50 projects, including Cleaning from the Core. Those needs have already been met in those projects, but we have many more. Many of our local businesses and organizations have shown their spirit about making Spokane one of the most compassionate communities and cities in the country, and they have signed up as different teams. About 50 businesses and organizations have already signed up as teams. My request to the community today is to keep volunteering. We have also, in a spirit of giving, issued a good-natured challenge to our friends at the Spokane County and other municipalities to join us in this initiative across our region. Spokane County, which is represented today, like I said, by Commissioner O'Quinn, has stepped up in a big way with projects that are working to rally volunteers in the county. They have also put up volunteer opportunities, in particular the very successful and a huge event my family has attended, the Bike Swap, which is an event this weekend where really we can get more kids and more people onto bikes at an affordable price, and they're looking for volunteers to help in that effort. On the service side, Liberty Lake and our own Fairchild team are just a few of our partners stepping up in a big way to support projects that still need volunteers. Both already have strong reputations for volunteerism, and we're excited to see them embrace this opportunity to support our region's efforts to build a compassionate community. Our ultimate goal is to be a community that isn't just compassionate next week or within the city limits, but a region with a mindset of compassion and a heart for year-long service. Some of those year-long opportunities are right around the corner. We're coming up quickly on the festival season in our community with the Lilac Festival, Bloomsday, and Hoop Fest, who have tens of thousands of volunteer opportunities. Spokane citizens have demonstrated their heart of service by volunteering on these and others of smaller magnitude. More than 2,500 people just in the last month have registered as volunteers through the SpokaneGives.org website, and there still is a week to go. They've offered to help out during Spokane Gives Week and beyond. Already they've met up to 200 needs that our local agencies have posted on the site, and those numbers continue to rise. Spokane Gives Week is about shining the light on the needs that exist in our community, on volunteering that happens every day, and providing a tool to make those who want to serve have an opportunity to go to a single spot to find out those opportunities to serve. A single act can make a collective difference. Today and every day is a good day to volunteer in Spokane. For those for looking for ideas to volunteer, please do go to SpokaneGives.org. It's loaded with several opportunities to do just that. And I want to take another opportunity to thank Commissioner O'Quinn and the Chief for coming out here today to show your support. I'll be excited to see you out there next week on different opportunities throughout the county. Thanks again for joining me here today. Appreciate it. Thanks, Chief. Thanks. I'll finish with another smarter way of building a stronger community, especially in the infrastructure area, and also engaging our citizens. And another reason for Vision 2020 is another goal of ours is to engage more citizens. As citizens move around our city, they gain a valuable perspective on the city's transportation system, both the things that are working well and, quite frankly, some of the parts that need some work. We are asking citizens to share that knowledge using a new online mapping tool. That tool will help us inform and update the transportation system in the utility chapter of the city's comprehensive plan called Link Spokane. That initiative was released a few months ago through a Linked Spokane pamphlet that was found in some of our local newspapers. The public can now note the locations, intersections, and stretches of street that are problematic and those that are working well. Directions on how to use this new smart tool, this mapping tool, are provided on the site, but essentially the user can draw a route and comment on what works for them and what does not. This gives people who can't make a meeting in the traditional form of our town hall and other ways a way to provide that feedback from the comfort of their own home or their workplace. That feedback will make us smarter about how we approach transportation in our community. It'll inform the Link Spokane work, which will address the future needs of transportation users, including vehicles, freight, transit, bicyclists, and pedestrians, while identifying opportunities to leverage coordinated utility infrastructure improvement. The online mapping exercise complements our work already being completed as a part of our initiative of Link Spokane. Information collected during a February workshop was added to that mapping tool. Users of the tool will be able to read that information as well as new information that is added. Two versions of the mapping tool are available, one for gathering information about modes of transportation and another with a bike and pedestrian focus. The tool is available at SpokaneCity.org by searching Link Spokane. The Link Spokane process is only one part of the city's overall update of the comprehensive plan that will make us stronger, and we are doing it in a smarter way. The plan is the one of a unified document that coordinates and guides all city's departments as we look at building a stronger community. So in closing, as you can see today, it's an exciting day as the launch of our electronic PCR and great opportunities to provide a safer community. Again, it's great to have our partners at the county and Fairchild to join us in Spokane Gives, an unprecedented week of service in our community. And finally, obviously, the engagement of our citizens Michigans on developing a stronger community through an integrated transportation program as we launch or continue with the initiative of Link Spokane. With that, I'll take any questions. Chief, if you could comment on the cost, the one-time cost and the ongoing cost, and you probably need to be up here so the rest can hear you, but it is funded through the EMS levy.
Sure. The capital cost initially was around $30,000 with an ongoing cost of around $35,000 to store those protected patient care items, that HIPAA-compliant system that we developed and that we contracted with. That's an ongoing cost. It's a long answer to a short question. Can we do it offline? Because I know he's got a lot of places to go, and it's detailed. I'd like to be able to talk to you.
Is that $35,000 per year? Is it like cloud service?
Much like many of the medical facilities in Spokane, we're relying more and more on cloud-based services. It's the next generation, the next step into affordably storing confidential data. So that is part of that, as well as an ongoing maintenance and constant updates to the program that is out in the tablets and in the field. We can talk.
Any other questions? All right. Thanks for everybody being out here. We have a few other folks here that are available for interviews and or the EPCR also.